Thank you to all the people and sponsors that made this possible. You guys rock.
Good morning, gamers. It's currently Monday, January 25th at 8:54 a.m. and I have to build 20 gaming computers by Friday for Tampa Bay for the Super Bowl.
This all started September of last year with this tweet. Ambitious goal, give away 20 gaming computers this December by Christmas. Well, it's currently July of the following year. Tweet didn't age very well, did it? Thing is, there's still millions of Americans and hundreds here in the city of Atlanta that do not have functional modern computers. I wanted to provide modern computers to those who needed them, but I wasn't exactly sure how to find people who fit the bill. I called one of my friends, Brian, who is a coordinator at the Forever Young Foundation, a foundation that serves children facing significant physical, emotional, and financial challenges by providing them with academic, athletic, and therapeutic opportunities unavailable to them. So I asked Brian, hey, I want to donate 20 gaming PCs this Christmas. Can you point me in the right direction? And he was like, yeah, man, I got you. But what if instead of Christmas, we did the Super Bowl instead? I mean, yeah, sure, if you want. Somehow I have to build 20 gaming computers and they might be unveiled Super Bowl weekend. I guess let's get started, right? The first step to building these computers is figuring out what components I already have. There's just one problem. I hoard. Like, a lot. This is 5 years worth of computer parts, and it's just room number one. The process took me 3 full days to complete, and when I checked how many components I had laying around, I was shocked. Almost 200 PC parts, some of which I even forgot existed.
We did it. We did it, Joe.
With that many computer parts, I should be able to easily build 20 gaming computers, right? Wrong. As many of you already know, I enjoy low-end, mid-tier, and retro hardware, so about a third of my components couldn't have been used for this project simply because they were too old. I mean, I have a whole bag full of just DDR SDRAM, and here's another bag full of an assortment of Core 2 quad processors. So yeah, I mean, if the computer components are older than my viewers, it's probably not a good idea to use them. So when the dust settled, I only had enough components to build maybe 12 computers, but I had promised 20. I was prepared to drop whatever cash I had in order to get all the components I need to make this project happen. Thankfully, some wonderful, wonderful, wonderful people and companies helped out a little bit.
Seriously though, shout out to all the sponsors and people who made this possible. I have a tribute for you guys for being so awesome. Enjoy.
With the computer parts organized, the sponsor supplying the rest of the parts, and the Super Bowl spot secured, I excitedly started actually building these computers.
Life goes so fast, I've been living so slow. Let's just leave, do whatever we want to.
It usually takes me 90 minutes to fully build a computer without installing Windows 10 and all the necessary drivers. During the first week or so, I was able to finish 8 computers and was on a roll to get the rest of them done well before Super Bowl weekend. Everything was going smoothly and according to plan until disaster struck. I'm being dramatic here. We weren't able to make the Super Bowl unveil event happen because of COVID. Unfortunate, but very understandable. Instead, Brian and his team set up a charity livestream event featuring Dr. Disrespect and a few NFL Hall of Famers to raise money for the Boys and Girls Club in Tampa Bay. Here, they showcased the PC building event, which was really kind of them to do. Well, the livestream happened in February, and the computers weren't complete until months after. So, what happened? Well, I just kind of had my priorities mixed up. On a more serious note, life just happened a lot faster than I was expecting. Between January and now, I went full-time with YouTube, but then decided to stop that. So I was transitioning out of that and applying for new jobs. I moved about 3 times the last 6 or 7 months. Also had to apply for citizenship, new passports, just life. I guess you can consider this my official apology, which, ironically, I'm checking more and more YouTuber cliches every single day. Not to make excuses, since this project should have been done months ago, but I hope even now it would still be beneficial to the recipients. But as soon as I garnered some free time and motivation, I continued the PC building. And well, I really, really enjoyed it. It was very therapeutic because it was so consistent and habitual in a time in my life where things were kind of up in the air. I did about 2 to 3 computers a day, and I was able to finish the rest of them within a week.
These are all the computers. It doesn't look like that much. It doesn't look like 20, but I promise that it is. So we have to do the next thing, which is, how did they perform? Hopefully they're not slow, right? We don't want that.
So many of you guys know me as the budget-oriented computer guy. So you're probably thinking that I built many of these computers with bottom of the barrel, super budget computer components. Obviously, have a little bit more faith in me. I'm going to be giving these computers away, so I want them to at least perform decently well. There's a lot of different ways I could make sure that these computers are up to par, but one thing I wanted to make sure is that they could all play one game, Minecraft. No, seriously, Minecraft is one of the best-selling games of all time that's also used in a lot of educational teachings and has a high overlap with kids interested in STEM, which is perfect. So if the slowest computer can play Minecraft at 60 FPS with respectable settings, I'm happy. So we're going to benchmark the slowest computer that I've built, a middle-of-the-pack computer, and then one of the fastest computers so you guys can get a wide range of what performance these people can expect. Let's get started. The fastest PC has a Ryzen 7 2700X, 16 gigs of RAM, and a GTX 1080. It breezed through Minecraft and rarely dipped below 100 FPS. It was a similar story in Unigine Heaven 4.0, averaging 140 FPS on the extreme preset. Cinebench R20 was more or less the same, completing the benchmark quickly with a score in the 4000 range. The next PC we have is actually the slowest of the bunch. It's a dual-core Pentium G5400 with hyper-threading, 8 gigs of RAM, and a 750 Ti 2 gig. Unigine wasn't an ideal experience, but it stayed above 25 FPS on average, good enough for gamers who have used Intel HD graphics in the past. Cinebench R20 took a millennium to finish, and when it was all said and done, the score wasn't the best, but hey, it's a dual-core processor, and it tried. And finally, Minecraft. The experience is rocky when you first load up the game, but dramatically improves after about 30 seconds. FPS was all over the place, but you can fix that with a 60 FPS frame cap. The final computer had a Ryzen 5 2600X, a GTX 960, and 8 gigs of RAM. It floated through Minecraft without any substantial hiccups or slowdowns using modest settings. Unigine Heaven 4.0 was mostly fine until I noticed something kinda out of the ordinary. Yeah, that GPU temperature was way too high. I opened the video card and found crusty thermal paste, and after replacing it, the temperatures were as good as new. The Unigine Heaven score was about expected for a PC of this caliber as well. And lastly, the computer performed where I expected in Cinebench R20, so no complaints there. And that's a wrap. Computer performance is good, and each PC has a decent upgrade path, even the lower end ones. All that's left is to get these computers into hands that need them.
This is what 5 hours of sleep looks like. Today is when the project is basically out of my hands. We're going back to my parents' place to drop off the rest of the computers, get them prepped up for 8 a.m. when our friend Ray is gonna pick them up and then send them over to Tampa to the Boys and Girls Club, who will be using them. All right, I don't wanna spend any more time than I need to, so let's head out.
PC prep was quick and painless. I made sure each PC had a power cord, an HDMI cable, and a USB Wi-Fi adapter to go with it. And yeah, almost a year later, that is all 20 computers built, tested, and ready for shipping.
Hey, did it, Joe.
Ray should be here soon, so
let's get it, baby. Get him.
Ray, a trucker who works with the Forever Young Foundation, stopped by and helped load up the computers. Super nice guy and great at what he does. With the help of my brother, shout out to him.
Tell him, Namdi. Tell him.
Everything was ready to go within the hour. Honestly, I was worried about the computers breaking on their journey to Florida, but Ray packed the computers well and assured me that everything would be fine.
Appreciate that. Y'all got the picture?
Yeah, we got the picture.
Okay, cool.
All right. See you, man. Later. Take it easy.
Man, literally almost a year later, we have finished the project. We built 20 computers, gaming computers. We sold them for $0. And I couldn't be happier. The Tampa Bay Boys and Girls Club did receive the computers safely and distributed them to the kids. If I get the chance, I'll show pictures and videos, but I might skip on that just for the privacy of the children. Now, originally, I wanted this to be a collaborative effort where people donate computer parts and I build the 20 computers with said donations. Logistically, that is just a nightmare for one gamer like myself. But if you still want to contribute and help out the Tampa Bay Boys and Girls Club, there's one way you can help. So I recently dropped some merch. It's called the Cute Hardware Lineup, and it's some witted, pun-filled dad humor pasted on shirts, sweatshirts, mugs, and bucket hats. Through the month of September, all of the proceeds that come from the merch will go straight towards the Tampa Bay Boys and Girls Club, where I donated these computers. You get some middle-of-the-road quality, yet adorable merch that belittles the GPU shortage, and you help out some kids in the meantime. So, seems like a win-win to me. The goal is $2,000, which will sponsor 20 students at the Boys and Girls Club for an entire week. And if we reach that goal of $2,000, I will bleach my hair blonde. And finally, I just want to say thank you. Thank you to the sponsors, and I want to make sure I get every single one of them. Thank you to Micro Center, NZXT, Arctic, Cooler Master over the years, ShopUCW, and the Chris team, Marcus Fish, everybody else who donated. You guys really made this possible. And then shout out to you guys, the fans, the viewers, everyone who's been watching the channel since its inception. Without you guys, I would not have had the means, the resources, the computer parts to make this happen. So you guys are incredible, 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 incredible. So thank you. At the end of the day, I hope this video is, at the very least, entertaining, at its best, inspiring. I think everybody, if you have it within your means to donate something like this, a computer which is so widely used nowadays, you should totally do it. It doesn't even have to be 20 gaming computers. It doesn't even have to be a gaming computer. You can donate an old computer to a local shop or a free geek, whatever you want, and it would still be very useful. In terms of actually uploading videos, I know I've been gone for a little bit. Like I said, life just kind of happened, but I'll start uploading more frequently. I have a full-time job now, but I do videos on the weekends just for fun. So maybe one or two times a month, I'll start uploading content. So be on the lookout for that. With all that being said, I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. Peace.